The UPS man is here. Yay! Thank you, my friend.
There you are. Thank you.
Have a great day.
This is the Firefly FFDCS. Firefly's take on a classic double cut design. This is the second run of these guitars, and in this video we will explore the differences between the first run and the second run. We'll also put this guitar through its paces and see what it can do. If that sounds like something you might be interested in, stick around.
Hello there again, boys and girls, and welcome to yet another edition of Live from the Tape Farm. Today we are going to be looking at the Firefly FFDCS, Firefly's double cut, single pickup, junior, Les Paul Junior sort of guitar. This is the second run of this guitar. I also have a first run, which I will get down for you now. And this is the first run of those guitars. The main difference between the first run and the second run is the first run has a wraparound bridge. The second run has the tune-o-matic. That is the two main differences. I will tell you the second run is a much better guitar for a number of different reasons, and we'll get into those. I have replaced the wraparound bridge on the first run because the way they, where they placed the bridge made the bridge kind of kick up. And I have a video on this guitar, a couple of videos on the first run of this guitar that you can check out. And I will put the link like here. But this guy, I feel is a much better guitar, mainly because of the bridge. That tune-o-matic bridge, the intonation setup is much easier, and I didn't have to buy something else. On this guitar here, on the first run, this guy, again, I had to buy that bridge because the original wraparound bridge was not set properly. It needed to be back a little bit. Where it was placed on the guitar was about, I estimated somewhere around 3/16 of an inch too far forward towards the nut. It needed to be back a little bit. And if they would have done that, it would have been perfect. Then if I decided to get a new bridge, it would just been, I decided because I wanted to get a new bridge. This guy, I had to get a bridge because it was not possible to properly intonate and get the guitar set up in a way that was comfortable to play. Because of the way the bridge kind of kicked up on the end on the first run, the action was a bit high. This guy here, no such trouble. Right out of the box, it was very playable. I did lower the action slightly. I did adjust the truss rod slightly. The fretwork on this guy was a lot better than the fretwork on the first run. The frets were polished, not like to a mirror finish, but much better than all of the other Fireflies that I've gotten. I would say the fretwork on the FFLP and the fretwork on this are very comparable. Didn't really need to do a lot of work to the frets. Like I said, just a little bit of setup stuff, lower the action, just the truss rod slightly, and that was it. Nut was cut really well, and it just played. The tuners have been very good, as were the tuners on the first run. I've literally tuned this guy up, stretched the strings, and actually when I first got out of the box, I was tuning it up, I stretched the string and doink, and the E string broke off in my hand. That's happened before. The strings that come on guitars right out of the box generally aren't the best strings in the world. So you'd be better off replacing them anyway, which I did as soon as that string broke. I'm like, no big deal. I have a set handy, put on some Ernie Ball 10s, and there we are. And this thing has stayed relatively in tune since I got it out of the box. You know, tweaks here and there, but Nothing major. Nothing major at all. So very good work with the tuners, potentiometers, and internals of the cavity. Fantastic. Full-size pots, big old orange capacitor. They work, and they do their job. It's not much to it. So yeah, finish-wise, I absolutely love. I'm not usually a sunburst guy, but this guy looks really good. I really like the burst on this guitar. Where the neck joins the body, very clean. I took the pick guard off to look at the tenon, and I've got a video of that. So good size tenons, not extremely short. Sometimes on the budget end guitars, you'll see a very short neck tenon when they're gluing them in, which leads to not as strong of a bond. But this is really good. The pickup here, I would say, is very comparable to the pickup in the first run. I think it may be a little bit more open sounding. I did need to wax pot the pickup in the first run because it was very microphonic and would squeal with any sort of gain. That's not the case with this one, as you will hear. I did when I do the demo. I've done demos usually before with amp models just because it's easier. And I don't have to set up mics and stuff. So, but I've heard some people complain about that, where they were just like, oh, you should use a real amp and yada, yada, yada. Okay. So I got me a quote unquote real amp. I have a couple of other amps, but I wanted to do is get an amp that everybody could afford. Most people, the people who could afford this guitar could also afford this amp. So I got one of the Monoprice Stage-Rite 15-watt tube amps. ELA 84 power tubes, which can be a little fuzzy, but otherwise, you know, this amp is really, really good. Very pleased with it right out of the box. And so I figured I would do the demo using that amp, since it is, is an amp that folks who could afford this guitar could also afford that amp. They normally go for about $250. I got it on sale for like $200, I think, $199. Might have been like a Black Friday sort of thing. And been really happy with the amp. So it's a good little amp. So I used that for the demo on this guitar. Gain up pretty high on some of the distorted parts, and this guy did not squeal at all. I can tell you the first run guitar absolutely would have squealed doing what I was doing with it. Wax potted that pickup, and it's been rock solid. Haven't had any problem with it. But I don't think I really need to wax pot this one. So a little bit of an improvement there. Sound quality wise, I think they both sounded great right out of the box. But this one's just not as microphonic. Weird. Just because I'm really, really happy with it, doesn't mean there aren't little things that you need to be aware of. Whenever I do these videos, I hear people say, oh, you do nothing but complain. I'm not complaining. I am pointing out to you what, when you buy a guitar at this price range, what are some of the things that you're going to be putting up with? Some people don't want to do that. There are people who just won't put up with certain things, and that's fine. Don't buy one of these guitars. But if you're like, wow, that's a really good guitar, good sounding guitar, great playing guitar, for $140, yeah, not a bad deal. I'll sink the $140 and put up with a couple of little minor issues. So let's talk about what some of those tiny minor imperfections were. Where the nut, when the nut was cut, there's a little bit of a scrape. The biggest thing for me, placement of the tuners, but the tuner for the D string is just a little bit set in. It's not out as far as the G, so it just feels a little weird. The tuning key is very close to the headstock as compared to the other keys, as you can see there. So that's a tiny minor thing. I think it might just be that it's kind of, I need to kick it out a little bit. But out of the box, that was one of the little things. Another little thing is in the paint. You see that little white dot? I thought that little white dot was a piece of the styrofoam that was sticking, you know, like a static, so I kept trying to wipe it off, and then realized it didn't wipe off. And then I started, you know, rubbing on it. It's like, no, that's under the finish. That is what that is. So I'm not sure what it is, but it is, it's a little fleck of something that got under the clear coat, and there it is. And it's right there when you look down. When you look down, there it is. So if that's something that's going to drive you insane, yeah. And again, you probably won't get that on your guitar, but that's what I got on mine. And just letting you know, for me, not a big deal. Don't really care. Overall, the fit and finish, other than those couple of little things, is outstanding. Then, like I said, the neck is the fretwork and the fret ends are great. I've actually seen video and pictures where people have shaved the back, this heel down a little bit. They've shaved this heel down and then refinished the neck and stuff, and it looks great. For some people, I absolutely get why that's a thing. For me being up here, I mean, I'm not up here all that much. So let's be realistic. I'm not up there all that much to really bother me. But for some players, I could absolutely see why having that angle right there might be a bit of a nuisance, and why you might want to shave that down a little bit. But for me, it was fine. And I've been playing the heck out of this thing. So you may notice in the background, the studio is a little bit of a mess because I am I'm trying to get some stuff done. Actually, later today, I'm having surgery on my, I have really bad carpal tunnel in this hand. And so I'm having carpal tunnel. So I'm trying to get a lot of things done, including this video, because I want to get this out before I wouldn't be able to play guitar for a few weeks. So I've been playing the heck out of all these guitars because I won't be able to play for a few weeks. So it's gonna be very sad. But yeah, been playing the heck out of this thing, and it's stellar. It really is a great guitar for $140. Man, you can't go wrong. So much better, and then, well, not so much better, but for me, a lot better than the first run, just because of the bridge. The fact that you don't have to go buy another bridge, you don't have to worry about trying to figure out a way to get the action lower and getting it to intonate and everything. Just so much easier. Very little adjustment. I had to do a very minor adjustment to the bridge to get the intonation correct. Just overall, like on a scale of 1 to 10, again, keeping in mind its price range, I mean, a 9.5, because little things like that don't really bother me. That may bother you. Little things like this don't really bother me. The fact that is closer, I could probably fix that, but I didn't want to fix it until after I did the video. So, but yeah, there we go. Let's look and see what this guy can do. Well, there you have it. The Firefly FFDCS. I still wish they would just come up with a better name for these guitars. But a lot of fun. Great little guitar. Love the new amp, too. I may end up doing a little video on the amp, but the new amp is really good. That was mic'd with a Sennheiser 609E. Literally, I mean, if you saw the video, just draped over and put in front. Nothing major. And there you have it. So, comments, questions, concerns, cries of outrage, hit me up in the comments, and I will catch you guys later.
Hey folks, thanks for watching. The Tape Farm specializes in analog to digital transfers of many prosumer tape formats. From standard cassettes up to 16-channel multi-track recordings, we specialize in formats from manufacturers like Tascam, Fostex, Alesis, and others. So if you have some old tapes in your closet that you'd like to get converted to digital files that can be loaded into your DAW of choice to either relive or remix the past, send them on to us. You can check us out at thetapefarm.com.